tomorrow's pre-match ritual? What are you going for?
Probably
going to
be with the team, because that's all everyone
is. They're so bad
but
for
I don't
you.
Have the big one.
Well, don't get the big one then.
I don't know where the little ones are.
So we've just arrived at the stadium, just over an hour to kick off. Still waiting on team news, that should be coming out shortly, so looking forward to that. Fun fact, Chris Gerkins actually just walked past us and me and Amy had a little bit of a fangirl. We smiled at him, he gave us an eyebrow raise, so it's sort of right, isn't it? But yeah, we'll let you know once we get inside, let you know the team news and give you our thoughts before the game.
What's your thoughts about the game today?
Be an interesting game, tough game. I mean, Liverpool are starting to come into better form. I know the defeat last week to Chelsea was a bit of a pain in the backside, but playing against a very good, strong Man City side. You know, these are the tough games and the opposition that you want to play to try and, you know, build your confidence.
Yeah.
Could go either way, but I think it'd be a very close game. I could see it being a draw, perhaps. But
yeah,
even though if there was a winner, then I think it'd be just one goal in it, I suppose.
Really?
We just found the team news of City on, it's just come out on Twitter. So we've got Roebuck in goal, Morgan, BT, Houghton and Bonner, Walsh, Scott, Weir, Wooler, Emsley and Paris. What are your initial thoughts?
A bit surprised. I think Emsley's not normally a regular starter for them. Well, she hasn't been so far this season. I was expecting George Stanway to be in there, but maybe he's just mixing it up a little bit.
Tactical change, maybe,
yeah,
something like that.
Literally just could be something simple like that. No surprise by Paris up front.
No.
Best player for them, in my opinion.
No surprise of Houghton and Bonner either.
No, they've been solid at the back this season for City. So
I think we were all a bit sceptical at the start whether Bonner would actually play for City that much. And she's actually been I think she's nearly played every game that they've had so far.
Yeah, pretty much.
And she seems to have settled in really, really well with the whole City system and the way that they play.
Yeah.
Right from the goalkeeper throughout the up to attack.
Yeah,
so she's really settled in well. Likewise with Caroline Weir, she's on the pitch as well.
Well, at the beginning she wasn't really getting in, was she? In the side.
I think it was just a matter of adjusting.
Literally, yeah.
Because some players just naturally adjust better than others do. And like City do play a different style of football to
they
what
do,
we play.
Yeah.
So it's definitely, it might have taken her much more time to adapt, but absolutely no surprise to me that they are both in the side today.
No, absolutely not.
Seeing that we just saw all the players out there talking earlier and they're all, I think it was Weir and Coombs all chatting together,
having
a catch up, which it's actually really nice to see.
Yeah, it really is.
Because obviously they played together for years.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've changed seats.
Yeah.
The Liverpool starting 11 has just come through. I'll quickly run through it for you.
Yeah.
We've got Preuss in goal, which was not what we were expecting.
No.
Satara Murray, Bradley Auckland, Fahy, Robe, Roberts, Coombs, Christy Murray, Charles, Daniels and Babajide.
So the first one is not Preuss, but Daniels for me.
Yeah.
Simply because she has not started the game for us yet.
Yeah. I'm quite excited about that, you know?
I am. I'm really looking forward to it.
It's that injection of pace up front.
I think the midfield, Fahy... Oh no, she's in defence, isn't she?
Fahy's dropped in defence because Matthews got a head injury against Chelsea.
So with the midfield being Roberts, Coombs, Christy Murray.
Yeah.
Christy Murray's literally going to pick out them balls for the front three.
I'm very much excited for her coming back into the squad as
really
well.
Excited.
Sorry to interrupt you there.
No, it's okay. Really excited because she can pick that pass for us.
Yeah.
So for them three up front, it's just pure pace. So they will get onto the end of them passes or you know, on the end of the classes and stuff like that. So I'm excited by that. Preuss, what's your thoughts on that?
Yeah. This whole Preuss situation for me, I'm very, very confused by it. Just purely because last week against Yeovil, not last week, I think it was 2 weeks ago now against Yeovil, she were out on the pitch, but yet she wasn't on the team sheet.
Yeah, it was very weird.
She was on the team sheet against Chelsea though.
She was.
I don't know what it is.
I don't know whether it's like something to do with. Is it just something to do with the league, maybe? Like,
I'm very not sure.
Because you can only have a certain amount of players like registered and stuff like that. So maybe she wasn't registered in time or just something.
I'm really very not sure.
Yeah. It's nice to see her back in.
And then Charles also back into squad. She did Charles, feature against Chelsea.
We missed her last week. We were questioning what the reason was. She must have just had a little bit of a niggle that she couldn't play with, which is fine. You don't want to risk it and have it out for longer than she needs to be.
Fahey in defence. I know we touched on it slightly, but
Fahey can play anywhere for me, to be honest.
Did you have another fangirl moment?
Yeah. Did you not? When she turned up in her car, and I was like, oh my god, it's Neen.
I think I've got the on video. That was Jake.
I'm not obsessed. I'm just like.
Yes, she is.
I'm not. I'm not Lucy Bronze level obsessed like Amy is.
No.
Just got off the bus on the way home now. Disappointing game.
Yeah.
3-0 defeat's never nice, no matter who you play. But hats off to City. They're just like
absolutely
next level.
Unplayable, genuinely.
Yeah, next level. In terms of our performance, I think Rube really stood out for us.
And Bradley Auckland.
And Bradley Auckland really stood out. No one else really. If you had to pick a man of the match, it would be them too. You wouldn't.
No one else's performance really standed out for me.
Yeah, standed out.
Stood out. it's been a long day.
Yeah, but like City just have, like, we were saying you couldn't pick players from our team to walk straight into their team. It just wouldn't happen.
No, and you've got people in that City team. They've got England like veterans in their team, such as Steph Houghton, Keita Paris and all of them, and they just are so talented as a group. So they've got those players that are highly, highly experienced. Yeah. And when obviously us being a new team, and I feel like we say this every week, but genuinely as a new team, you can't expect everything to just click straight away, and we're still in that transition and learning process.
Yeah,
whereas City have their foundations already,
yeah,
and they're forever building with the likes of Georgia Stanway and Emsley who started the game today.
Yeah.
So it's really difficult to come at it from a really good like attitude, yeah. But at the same time, you've got to give the girls credit.
Yeah.
They did go out there and put their effort in today. They really did.
Yeah, they did. But unfortunately, it just
kind of slipped away from us. The first half was brilliant, though. We contained them in a way.
There was plenty of possession for both teams, I think. But
as you were saying,
We didn't press them at all. No. That was our route to try and make them go
in one day. Us to do, and we had opportunities to do it, and we just didn't. So
no. Tough day at the office, but we'll obviously talk about this more when we get in the office next week. Yeah. So yeah, stay tuned. Unlucky defeat, but we go again.